अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज़ समर अकरम। द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज़ आर्टिफिशियल बॉडी ऑर्गन्स एंड बॉडी टिश्यूज़। ओके, दीज आर द कंटेंट्स। आर्टिफिशियल बॉडी ऑर्गन्स, आर्टिफिशियल बॉडी टिश्यूज़, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेस ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल ऑर्गन्स, एरिया ऑफ एप्लीकेशन, ट्रांसप्लांटेशन इन USA एंड इटली, artificial kidney, heart, liver, organs, ear, and multi-organ transplantation and xenotransplantation. Artificial organs. What are artificial organs? Nowadays, artificial devices are not able totally and indefinitely replace the loss of function of all vital organs, and artificial organs can be used only to bridge the time of transplantation, which must be considered the first choice in a therapeutical approach of many chronic diseases. Since general population aging process is leading to an increase of organ demand, the gap between performed and requested transplantation is hard to fill. Xenotransplantation is nowadays only an experimental alternative solution, and we have to do our best using available artificial organs to increase and improve the survival of patients waiting for transplantation. In this, we will define artificial organs comprises complex medical devices that have active mechanical or biochemical functions such as heart, lungs, kidney, liver, and pancreas. The United Network of Organ Sharing reports the importance of organ sharing, like I think 7,40,000 and 3,900 plus are waiting for transplantation. The number of donor is 1999 and 10576 and 216555 transplantation have been performed in the same year. The Italian solution is well described by detail from the Italian Society of Nephrology, showing an increased transplantation activity in the year between 1922 and 200, and minor increase in donor organs. The aging population will be described by Professor Gimepapa, and his lecture is leading to an improved increase in number of patients and waiting list. Unfortunately, the gap between organ demand and organ availability could hardly disappear because of storage of donor organs, but on the contrary, the increasing number of transplantations seems to be able to fulfill the increasing demand. Therefore, while waiting for alternative solution like xenotransplantation, we have to do our best by using artificial organs. Bioartificial organs manufacturing technologies are a series of enabling techniques that can be used to produce human organs based on bionic principle. During the last 10 years, significant processes have been achieved in the development of various organs manufacturing technologies. According to degree of automation, organ manufacturing technologies can be divided into three main divided: fully autonomous and semi-autonomous and handwork or handmade. Each have advantages and disadvantages. For bioartificial organs manufacturing, one of the most promising bioartificial organs manufacturing technologies is used to combine multi-nozzle three-dimensional printing techniques and automatically assemble personal cells along with the other biochemical to build exclusive organ substances for defective field of human. This is the first time that advanced bioartificial organs manufacturing technique have been reviewed. These technologies hold the promises to greatly improve the quality of health and average lifespan of human beings in the near future. Organ failure is the leading cause of mortality all over the world, despite advances in international pharmacological and surgical therapies. Bioartificial organ manufacture have been long-term dreams since then, beyond the memory of man. Throughout history, people have tried many ways to prolong life through a substitution and restoration of defective failed organs. Currently, orthopedic organ transplantation is the only effective way to achieve this. However, it is seriously limited by issues such as donor shortage, high price, immune rejection, and ethical conflict. With the rapid development in the science and technology, some advanced material processing technologies such as multi-nozzle rapid protoporphyrin, additive combined modeling, decolorization, mixture regeneration, and electrophoresis and magnetic adoption of technology, some advanced materials are used. How to resemble, this tells us how to resemble heterogeneous living cells with prestige architecture, including hierarchical, vascular, nuclear, lymphatic world, while ensuring that the corresponding functionalization is released. In one of the main concern of bioartificial organs manufacturing technologies, generally an artificial organ is an engineered device that can be implanted or integrated into human body infection, while living tissues to replace a natural organ to duplicate or augment a specific function or function so the patient may return to normal life as soon as possible. According to material used, artificial organs can be divided into three main classes: mechanical, made of inanimate polymer, or biochemical, or biochemical, made up of partially living cells, and biological, made up of living cells. With living tissues, then I will define artificial body tissues. Artificial body tissues could be produced by using various biofabrication techniques. A predefined pattern for the material and cell may be obtained. Conventional method of cell culture often performed in two-dimensional environment, consequently limiting the tissue structure of planar from which is very difficult from complex 3D structure in organism. With living tissues, to replace a natural organs or to duplicate or augment a specific function or function so patient may return to normal life as possible. According to the material used, artificial organs can be divided into three main classes: mechanical, biological, and biochemical. Normally, the former two classes can only partly and temporarily replace and repair the failed organ in human body, while the biological class can totally be permanently restored. Defective in this article, only biological manufacturing are used. An artificial organ is a human-made organs. It is used or an artificial tissue that is implanted or integrated into a human, interfacing with living tissues to replace a natural organs to duplicate or augment a specific function or function so that patient may return to normal life as soon as possible. The replaced function does not have to be related to life support, but it often is. For example, replacement bone and joint such as those found in hip replacement could also be considered artificial organs. Implied by definition is that the device must not be continuously threatened to a stationary power supply or other stationary sources such as a filter or chemical processes units. It is thus a dialysis machine, while a very successful and critically important life support device that almost completely replaces the duties of kidneys. It's not an artificial organ. An artificial organ, it may be a device designed to replace, duplicate, or augment functionally or cosmetically a missing, desired, or otherwise incompatible part of body, either temporary or permanently, and which require a non-biological material interface with the living tissues. The various processes are involved in manufacturing of artificial organs. These are tissue engineering, I will define tissue engineering. This is used of combination of cell engineering and material method and suitable biological and psychomaterial factors to improve or replace biological functions. Then bioprinting or 3D printing of tissues. Bioprinting, where living cells are precisely printed in certain pattern, has great potential and promises of fabricating engineered living organism. Industry, by using biomaterial which include metals, ceramic, polymeric and composites. In the laboratory, by using stem cell under regeneration. There are some advanced organ manufacturing technologies. During the last several years, a wide variety of organ manufacturing technologies have been exploited. These techniques include fully automated MNRP, partially autonomous, additive combined molding, manual culture, cell or porous. Nevertheless, the technique botless problem encountered in biomaterial cell therapy, tissue engineering during screening and other regenerative medicines used for more several have been and other devices have been used. Then, the half-autonomous additive combined modeling technologies have paved the way to develop a multi-scale vascular network comprising an anti-culture overcoat with autonomous capability, large blood vessels with a hierarchical arrangement of multiple cell types, small vascular structures with circular cross-sections and fully contiguous endothelium lining capillaries. It also first man-made prosfibrillar vascular network. In 2014, an imputable elliptic liver tissues with body vascular and neutral network in a synthetic polymer encapsulated. ADSC fibrinogen and hypercoat construct was manufactured using a combined four-nozzle 3D bioprinting. This is another fully autonomous organ manufacturing technology. With this technology, the concentration of cell-containing hydrogels can be greatly decreased or even omitted. ADSC in the construct was engaged in endothelial cell and hypocytes through two approaches. One, by incorporating growth factors inside the cell-laden hydrol lesions, and the other, applying a cocktail of growth factors as described above. A complete prosfibrillar hierarchical vascular network, including arteries, arterioles, veins, vessels, and capillaries, was created with the company of a branch network. The synthetic PLGA was used as an overcoat to protect the cell hydrogels from being washed out or swallowed up by bodily fluids and phagocytic cells. The PLGA coated cell construct can be connected with the body blood vessels with anti-structure and anti-pressure capillaries. This is another hugely important milestone in complex bio-artificial organs manufacturing. Then, areas of applications where these are applied: artificial bone, artificial skin, bionics, biomedical engineering, charcoal implant, ocular prosthetic, organ anatomy and organ transplantation. Then I will define transplantation in USA. The United Network of Organs, UNOS, report the importance of organ, UNOS 74039 parts are waiting for transplantation. The number of donors recovered in 1999 was 105676, and 21655 transplantation have been performed in the same year. Then I will define transplantation in Italy. The Italian situation is well described by data from the Italian Society of Nephrology, showing an increased transplantation activity in the year between 1990 and 2000 and a minor increase in donor organ. Moreover, the aging population, well described by Professor Gamfa in his lecture, is leading to impressive increase in number of patients. Then I will define artificial kidney. It is well known that kidney was the first organ to be successfully replaced, at least as record the exochronic function from the primitive called sacrificial kidney. Much subsequent amelioration have been achieved. For instance, as reported by Professor Biogeni, vitamin E coated dialysis membrane has been developed in order to decrease the oxidative stress, which seems to be contribute to the worsening of uremic anemia during dialysis session. We need dialysis if your kidney no longer remove enough waste and fluid from your blood and keep you healthy. This usually happens when you have only 10 to 15% of your kidney function left. You may have symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, swelling, and fatigue. However, even if you don't have these symptoms yet, you can still have high level of waste in your blood that may be toxic in your body. Your doctor is the best person who tell you about the situation. Then hemodialysis is a procedure where a dialysis much and a machine and special filters called artificial kidney or a dialyzer are used to clean your blood to get your blood into the dialyzer. The doctor needs to make an access or entrance into your blood vessels, and this is done with minor surgery, usually to your arm from usually to your arm. How a dialysis clean your body? The dialyzer or filter has two parts, one of your blood and one of your washing fluids called dialysate. A thin membrane separate these two parts. Blood cells, proteins, and other important things remain in your blood because they are too big to pass through the membrane. Smaller waste product in the blood, such as urea, creatinine, potassium, and extra fluids, pass through the membrane and are washed away. Where the hemodialysis is done? Hemodialysis can be done in hospital, in a dialyzer center. That is not important of a hospital or at a home. You and your doctor will decide which is the best place based on your medical condition and your wishes. Then I will define how long will each hemodialysis treatment last. In our dialysis center, hemodialysis is usually done 3 times per week for about 4 hours at a time. People who choose to do hemodialysis at home may do dialysis treatment more frequently, 4 to 7 times as per week. Your doctor will give you a prescription that tell you how much treatment you needed. Studies have been shows that getting the right amount of dialysis improves your overall health, keep your you out of hospital, and enables you to live long. Your dialysis team will monitor your treatment with monthly lab tests to ensure you're getting the right amount of dialysis. One of the major your dialysis care your team and may USA called urea reduction ratio. Another measure is called KTV, pronounced KTRV. Ask your device dialysis care treatment which measure that they are, what your number is, to ensure you're getting enough dialysis. Possibly may patient have their hemodialysis treatment at home. Generally speaking, patients on dialysis are advised to increase their protein intake and limit the amount of potassium, phosphorus, sodium, and fluid in their diet. Patients with diabetes and other health conditions may have additional diet restriction. It is important to talk to your dietitian about your individual needs. Your dialysis care team will monitor your treatment with monthly lab tests to ensure you get the right amount of dialysis and meeting your dialysis goal.
In some cases, the sudden or acute kidney failure dialysis may only be needed for a short time until the kidney get better. However, when chronic kidney disease progresses to kidney failure over time, your kidney do not better and you will need dialysis for the rest of your life unless you are able to receive a kidney transplant. When you being hemodialysis, the needles put in a fistula or graft may be uncomfortable. Most pain get used in that time. Your dialysis care team will make you sure that you are so comfortable as possible during treatment. Symptoms like cramps, headache, nausea, and dizziness are not common, but if you do have any of them, ask your dialysis care team if any of the following steps should be done with you. Slow down your fluid removal, which could increase for your dialysis, increase the amount of sodium in your dialysis, and check your high blood pressure. Meditation, adjust your dry weight targets, cool the dilated as title, use a special meditation to help prevent low blood pressure during dialysis. You can help yourself by following your diet and follow allowedness. The need to remove too much fluid during dialysis is one of the things that may make you feel uncomfortable during your treatment. Dialysis is expensive. However, the federal government Medicare program pays 80% of all dialysis costs for most of the patients. Private health institute or state medical aid may also help with the cost. Then I will define artificial heart. Professor Vigiano and his group have studied the potentially of different kind of artificial devices which can substitute cardiac damage function and reported a review from literature and how his own experience. On December 2, 1982 in Salt Lake City, the first artificial heart transplantation was performed. The heart-lung devices was confirmed in 2000 century and was also studied Lindbergh, the lonely flyer. It consists of a prosthetic pump to blood circulating and the oxygenated circuit. In 1963, it was introduced in the clinical practice and made the diffusion of non-beating heart surgery possible. The inertia aortic balloon pump, also named Conton plaster, introduced in 1965, is a partial myocardial support device. It was called the inventor of the artificial kidney, the one who promoted the research to obtain the implant artificial heart. This one was used to the first time by Cooley in 1969 as a bridge of transplantation, which was performed after 64 hours. The most famous artificial heart was Jervik 7, which allowed the patient to survive for more than 600 days of implantation. Deep rises observed the longest survival periods, which was 620 days long. As a matter of fact, many kinds of infection and embolic are complication limited the use of artificial heart. The use of artificial heart, the last prototype created the UPM as a streamlined artificial heart, and the Baxter, the so-called cardioplasty introduced in 1985, is also worth of mention. It consists of wrapping the filling heart in the braced dorsal muscles and stimulating it by current injection. The first cardiac transplantation was performed by Bermud on December 2, 1967 in Cape City. The first transplantation in Italy was performed on November 15th, transplantation which was gained valid clinical result. The Italian demand in 1997 was the 600 organs, of which 377 heart drawn from donor and 345 transplantation performed.
Then I will define artificial liver.
The attempt to replace liver function has not yet led to good result. Dialysis, plus prophylactic column perfusion and heartbeat devices have been used separately or in association, leading a sporocardiac good result. Nowadays, a bioreactor made of porcine or human hypocytes are under ascent. Professor Chamila processes an ideal solution for an undissolved tumorogenic human liver, but successful development or sufficient amount of such a kind of cell belong to the future. On the other hand, the approach to liver transplantation is totally different from kidney transplantation. The first orthopedic liver transplantation was performed in 1963, but reached real clinical use in 80s. Today, the excellent transplantation from living donor is mostly performed in the children, but it must use for adult too. The left lobe, which has regenerated in very time, is drawn from the donor. In 1997, the Italy, the need of liver transplantation required 600 organs and 466 were drawn from donor and 461 transplantation were performed.
Then I will define artificial pancreas.
The artificial pancreas use man-made technology to match the way of pancreas work. An artificial pancreas is man-made devices that is designed to receive insulin in response to changing blood glucose level. Is very similar way to a human pancreas. Artificial pancreas are being studied as a possible treatment option for people with type 1 diabetes and type 2 diabetes. There are three types of artificial pancreas: closed loop artificial pancreas, bionic artificial pancreas, and implanted artificial pancreas. The most widely tested artificial pancreas is a closed loop insulin delivery system and referred to as a closed loop artificial pancreas. Cambridge University has long pioneered research into the closed loop system. Their device is currently being tested on human under controlled and human conditions. It is made up of extremely worn insulin pump, which communicate wirelessly to a CGM worn as a patch on a skin. The CGM measure blood sugar level and the result is fed into a small computer, which calculate how much insulin need to deliver by insulin pump. The dose is then delivered into body, completing the cycle. In 2016, the European Commission announced it will fund a Cambridge University trial testing whether an artificial pancreas can help young children to manage type 1 diseases. In 2015, the word was introduced to iLet, a bionic pancreas that could help people with type 1 diabetes and manage the condition slowly through a device. The bionic pancreas developed by Dr. Edward Damon's Beta Bionic firm automatically control blood glucose level, comprising two insulin pumps which deliver an insulin and glucagon respectively. The pumps connect with the iPhone app via Bluetooth, enabling communication between the devices that help calculating the required doses needed, automated doses decision about insulin and glucagon, and made every 5 minutes based. Artificial pancreas system have become a hot topic of news in the last few years. Artificial pancreas system have become the topic of news in at least a few years. Then I will define artificial ear. Deafness is a relevant social problem which create enormous barriers and difficulty in social interaction, especially in children. The bionic ear was particularly studied by Professor Collett and his equips, which encase a series subtemporal root with three bilateral implants in the same surgical session. A prosthetic ear can be created to look very similar to a normal ear for a microtia patient by a specialized called a prosthetic or anaplastologist.
Two type of silicone prostheses may be created. One of the prosthetic that sit on skin. The other is an osteograted prosthesis that requires surgery to place two or three titanium plants into bones around the ears as a special metallic fixation devices onto which the prosthetic ear can be snapped into places. Advantages of prosthetic ear reconstruction. There are many advantages. Some are the ear can be made to look very realistic. It provides an option for patients who are not conditioned candidated for surgery. A prosthetic ear is simple processes which less risk with surgical construction. And there are also disadvantages. It is hard to handle. The seam where the silicone is next to normal skin matching skin color which changes throughout the ear may be difficult. Repeatedly removing and replacing the devices may cause breakage or need for the readjusted. Children can adjust may lose their ear while engaged in sport through any rigorous activity or it may just fall off. A prosthetic requires frequent care and periodic replacement. Then I will define multi-organ transplantation. Multi-organ transplantation are used to treat several failing or diseases organs by replacing them with healthy ones. Usually for the same donor, individual may be considered for the process when all the therapist and treatment have been unsuccessful in improving their conditions. During multi-organ transplantation surgery, two or more diseased organs can be replaced with healthy donor organs. Usually from some donor organ is transplanted at a time, but during the same surgery. Multi-organ transplanted are relative because the risk of multi-organ transplanted are generally higher than the risk of individual transplant that require medical accept and individual surgical skills that are only available at hospital. Then I will define xenotransplantation. Started in 1960s and performed in Rome, it still remains a large experimental field. Professor Musa well explained how the advances made in immunogenetics at the end of 20th century have allowed us to understand the molecular basis of rejection and how the availability of few immunosuppression drugs have renewed interest in the possibility of transplanting non-primitive animals' organs in human in this new perspective of using generally more discordant species. Pigs have taken on a prominent role in so far as they can be bred in large number of repeatedly research a size that is suitable for human transplantation. Their psychology is similar to that of human and their probability present fewer risk of term of transmittable diseases. Furthermore, as far as ethical consideration are concerned, it seems to be logical to assure that there is no subsequent difference between sacrificing them for purpose of food and sacrificing them for life-saving therapeutical purpose. Artificial organs can conventionally used into few groups. Bone joint replacement such as hip, knee, finger, total limb, skin, soft tissue replacement, skin, breast muscles, internal organs, heart, kidney, blood vessels, liver, pancreas, and sensory organs. A major concern is possible presence of the diseases in the base tissues which is used to create organs. Sometimes even a foreign body tissues is used to regenerate or reconstruct the original organ. In such cases, there is possibility that the tissue is already infected by other diseases. The entire coat of growing and transplantation of artificial organs is prohibited and thus limit the scope of application
to the general public. There are high chances of organ failure, and body may even take some time to adapt to a new organ. How the body reacts to the new organs may vary from person to person. If there is problem while the functioning of organ, you might need to do. Artificial organs can be replaced, decreased or demand organs, thereby providing the ailing patient with opportunity to lead a healthy or normal life. Artificial organs can meet a huge demand of healthy donor organs. There is huge list of patients who have urgent need of healthy organ but unable to find a suitable willing donor. A major stumbling block is in the form of organ rejection can be solved due to artificial organs, as artificial organs are created by taking the stem cells of the same person and of same organs. The possibility of rejection have been reduced significantly. With the help of regenerative medicine and artificial organs, then I will come towards conclusion. An unsubsequent success have been achieved in the field of organ replacement, but there are still many unsolved problems. The conclusion work can say following Professor Famularis' words: the current organ storage is estimated to keep outpacing organs demand for years to come. Bionic organ science may be valid option, allowing the bridging of some patient and waiting list to transplantation. Kidney, liver, heart, lung, and can be transplanted with long survival time. Xenotransplantation still remain an experimental approach. The real problem is transplantation is the availability of donor organs. This should be goal of healthy planning in the future. However, concerned with exist regenerating patient stratification and allocation criteria, timing and type of transplantation after organ recovery, and long-term risk of transmittable animal diseases and transfer of immunogenic molecule. Anyway, bioartificial organs should actually be regenerated as a part of wide armature to offer patient with filling organ functions. Okay, thank you so much. That's all about my topic. That's it.